Hello, Dr. Ron England, and this first lecture is going to introduce you to document object model and also the use of JavaScript in web pages. And this will be probably the first one where you actually start doing this. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you first the document object model, which is pretty straightforward here. So I'm going to go over here to my Firefox where I have Web Developer installed, and I'm going to bring up the DOM inspector. And actually bring the DOM inspector over here into this window so you can see it. And the DOM inspector lets you inspect the document object model. So in this case, my document has an element that's HTML, and inside the HTML element I've got the head and the body. Okay, now if I were to kind of bring this over here a little bit and I click on body, you notice it puts a red around the outside of the, you can see that red border that's there. Or I can say I can look at just a paragraph, or you can see it flash. I'll do it, go back to body, and then do it one more time. So it lets you inspect the actual structure of your document. Now the way this works is that when you create an HTML document, every element inside the document actually has it in itself parents and children. In the case of the HTML, which is one of the tags that you have here, it has two children, the head and the body. If you look at the body, it has multiple children, and these are elements that are at a first level underneath that specific element. And of course, in the case of the paragraph, it has the parent is the body. Now, that helps you easily define the structure of a document because you have this concept of children and parents. And in the case of the document object model, that concept is that each individual element in itself is a node, and that those nodes can have families of subnodes, children, and so you can allow for some fairly complex structure of documents. Now, what I'm going to do here is I'm going to show that also this capability of actually having, in this case, the image, I've defined an ID of that image, and I'm going to go ahead and pull this out to the side. Go ahead and close the document object inspector, and we're going to look at this. So in this case, the image has an ID of picture. So elements within the document object model can be referenced by their ID. Okay, well that's going to be very useful here. So what I've done here is I've gone ahead and put a button here, and the button is just simply a button tag. And what I'm going to do is when this button is clicked, I'm going to call a JavaScript function called reducePicture. Now this JavaScript is relatively straightforward. Up here, I've got this JavaScript function called reducePicture. And what I want to show is that you can use the document object model, the functions of the document object model that are built into JavaScript to get elements from the HTML document by their ID. So in this case, I'm going to define a variable called height, and that height is going to be equal to the document, which is the root element, and it's going to get an element of the document by ID. Okay, this is a there's not any multiples of picture here. I don't have to look at anything really dealing with a lot of structure in the document object model, but I have this element called image that is referenced by its ID picture, and I'm going to get the height. In this case, I'm going to also get the width, okay, of the same thing. Now, so I can actually have this document do something, what I'm going to have it do is it's going to reduce the picture size by changing the height and the width, which I'm still referencing by their ID, to be the height divided by 2 and the width divided by 2. So what that actually does, this picture is kind of large here. I don't want to have this massive picture. I can reduce the size. And it, when I click it, notice it reduced by a factor of 2. And a factor of 2. Now I can go, help me, I'm shrinking. I can get smaller and smaller and smaller. Okay, now if I want to go back to the original size, I can just reload the document and then I can reduce it again, same way. But what this demonstrates, okay, in code is that I have seen the document object model, which actually shows how I can see all the elements within a document, an HTML document. I've looked at taking a specific element called picture, okay, which I've referenced by ID, having a button call a function called reducePicture, which reduces the picture, which calls this function up here. I get the height and the width by referencing that element by its ID, the picture, and then taking that height and that width and then just reducing by 2 just to show that I can manipulate elements on a page. So this is a very good first getting started with the document object model and actually looking a little bit at JavaScript, and this is where we're going with actually doing website management and actually being able to create dynamic websites. Thank you. Good programming.